Beginning with the RMIT Super 8 group in the early 80s, Mousoulis entered into a period of intense productivity which saw him produce 39 Super 8 short films and three 16mm shorts. His work has been shown at the Melbourne Fringe Festival, the St Kilda Film Festival, the Melbourne International Film Festival, and the International Super 8 Festival at Montreal. The results of this have been several prizes and a body of work totalling over 6 hours of screen time, ranging in categories from narrative, experimental, and essayistic to documentary. Open City will be Mousoulis's 43rd work in a career just over a decade long.
The premise, the starting point, is that there's no violence in Melbourne.
Personally, you know, I do value emotion in the spectator, in the viewer, when he or she watches a film. And I try and, you know, create that emotion.
I play the part of James, who is the sort of main part or the journeyman character of the story that we follow, go through the story with. And James returns from Bosnia or from... some kind of, he's been working as a foreign correspondent for the Age newspaper in various war zones with his mate Jack, who's a photojournalist, who ends up saving James's life. James has got to a point of disillusionment.
For me, I always look for something which I consider sublime, which is the real. I look for a kind of the essence of life, as it were, and I find that in only certain kinds of films, certain films whose style is very minimal and precise and severe.
I'm talking to Georgina Campbell on the set of Open City. Can you say something about the character you play?
She's probably going through her Saturn return. She's just stabilising her own life. She's moved into a new place, had her hair cut off. She's involved in a theatre group, so she's obviously working on her own potential. And then her boyfriend of 4 years ago walks back into her life and changes things, obviously, or influences.
And what's Bill like as a director on the set?
He's quite amusing, actually. I love it when he starts storming around and flapping his arms. He just does it to himself, and ignores everybody, and just... Yes, up and down. I really like that. He's good with the actors. He lets us have our say. He's very flexible if we want to change things, and that's unusual. That's a definite bonus, I guess. So it's great.
You know, my film is about... one of the characters is a mass murderer, and of course Bresson has had characters that are mass murderers, and the example of the guy in La Jean, Bresson's last film. There's that shot in La Jean where the guy kills a hotel proprietor and his wife, and we don't see it at all. We see the man washing his hands in the basin, and the water turns red. Mm. That's the only indication, the only signification we have of that particular murder.
Thank you.
can override stylistic considerations when I watch a film. If it's a style I don't like, you know, I can override that by you know, just going through with the characters, and it still has to be a certain type of story. Like in Umbrellas of Cherbourg, which you mentioned, I like because there's a tragic feel to it, and yet a kind of very joyful feel to it too. It tends, that film does really kind of get in there and examine, not examine, but express love.
Yes, we have liftoff.
This is filmmaking, folks. There we go. You gotta put the tomato on just right.
Thank you.